The big question I get asked all the time, how do you manage to feed your children so many varieties of vegetable on a daily basis? Now, this is not a one-off day, evening when we are having vegetables. We have a mixed vegetable, many types of vegetable every day. My key secret is, number one, I know it's silly, but cut them fine. Somehow children prefer finely cut chopped vegetables as opposed to big pieces of vegetables. It doesn't go down their throat, and my children are the same. So I tend to finely chop the vegetables. Even though it takes me some time, I chop it. If you have help, you can instruct the help how to finely chop. Another thing I do, make it tasty. Now we all know kids, they love a little bit of ketchup, they love a little bit of chili sauce, they love a little bit of oyster sauce. I agree, it's better to make it from natural ingredients. Best is to avoid these sauces because they are full of sodium. But look at the big picture. The big picture is, how can we get our children to eat these nutrient-dense vegetables, these fiber-filled vegetables, instead of French fries or, you know, maybe foods that really don't have fiber. So these are just small tricks. Now I'm going to show you how I can make this amazing, tasty stir-fried vegetable. And you will see my kids actually eating it with great joy, right? So this is like a Chinese stir-fried vegetable. So I'm going to put some Chinese sauces in it. And so I put on my gas. I have some onion in this. You can put some garlic as well if you like. And you can actually cook these onions without oil. You can also put some, I put some avocado oil. You can put any cold press oil. It doesn't matter, right? You can add some ghee as well. So my pan will heat up, and these onions will actually cook in it. So the onions are sautéed a little bit. After that, I will actually put all my vegetables together. Another benefit in finely chopping it, that it all cooks together because they're so nicely finely chopped. So I have here yellow zucchini, carrots, I have mushroom, I have broccoli, and I put it all together. Now I will cook it together, and to this I will add maybe a tablespoon water. I put very little water in this because I want the vegetables to actually cook in its own juices. Stay tuned now for the real hack after this, how I get the children to eat these yummy, colorful vegetables. If you're wondering how long time does it take to cook, because it's finely chopped, evenly chopped, it doesn't take a long time. These vegetables have cooked in their own juices, and so they're a little bit crunchy and not really tasty yet for kids to eat. Right, so I will add some things. I put a little bit of pepper, just black pepper, white pepper, it depends what you want. I will not add salt to it because most of these sauces have enough salts in it. So I will put some oyster sauce, that are vegetarian oyster sauces. You know, you can buy any brand you want. And look how I will maintain the color of the vegetables. At the same time, I will make sure it's tasty because kids will only eat tasty food. Now I will use some ketchup too, but not much, just a few drops of ketchup because it has a little bit of sweet tangy taste. So that should be enough, a little bit of ketchup, and stir it a bit so I maintain the colors, right? Or when I put less water, the vegetables cook in its juices and it stays crunchy. Now this is one of my favorite sauces. It's a chili sauce, and you can buy any brand. There are many local brands, and I will put maybe one like big teaspoon or tablespoon, whatever you call it. And I am going to actually give this a good stir. Is this good for health? Maybe not. Now is this good for health? Sure, it's good for health. So I do a little bit of compromise sometimes, you know. You have to compromise with kids. That's how I get them to eat vegetables on a daily basis. I make different things, I use different sauces, and that's how they eat the vegetables. So I'm gonna taste this actually to see if the salt. I could add a little more of this ketchup and maybe just a few drops more. That's good. And maybe a little more of this chili sauce. This is not very spicy. This is like a sweet and sour chili sauce. There are many local brands that make it. I don't know a particular one, but I use any that I get my hands on. And so here, my vegetable stir fry is actually ready. And it's ready to eat. And oh, it smells delicious. If this video is helpful, hit the share button and share it with a friend.